The Mariana Trench is the deepest part of the world's oceans, with depths reaching close to 36,000 feet. The deepest part of the Mariana Trench is called the Challenger Deep. If you had to take Mount Everest and turn it upside down into the Mariana Trench, the tallest part of Everest would still be shy of the bottom by 7,000 feet. It's not until fairly recently that we've been able to learn about what lies at those insane depths. Number 21, hydrothermal vents. One of the first things you would notice in the Mariana Trench would be that the water is freezing, and once you've gotten past the point, you would see, then, the hydrothermal vents. Despite the fact that the water is so cold, these hydrothermal vents shoot out water that is around 700 degrees Fahrenheit. They're known as black smokers, and they're crammed with minerals that the sea life in the area feed and thrive on. Due to the intense pressure of the water at those depths, the water coming out from the vents never boils. The pressure kills off the boiling effect, but doesn't affect the temperature. Number 20, plastic bag. This is a truly shocking piece of information because if you think that the Mariana Trench is as deep as 36,000 feet, the last thing you'd expect to find down there is a plastic bag. A study was recently released confirming the find of the plastic shopping bag, the kind you get in grocery stores. The study also confirmed evidence that in the Mariana Trench there are certain parts with such high levels of pollution they are actually more polluted than some of the rivers in China. It's believed it may be caused by the breakdown of plastic in the water column that descends to the bottom of the ocean. Number 19, deep sea snailfish. In 2014, a team of biologists from the UK released footage of a very intriguing deep sea snailfish that they found in the Mariana Trench. There are 360 species of snailfish, and they all look like overgrown tadpoles with large heads and a transparent jelly-like body. Their flabby body helps to handle the intense pressure at such extreme depths. The one that the team spotted in 2014 doesn't have an official name yet, but they have nicknamed it ghostfish. Studies of the ghostfish continue. Number 18, deep sea dragonfish. This fish is the stuff that nightmares are made of. The deep sea dragonfish sports oversized, sharp teeth, pretty ugly mug, and is a true assassin of the deep. Despite the name of the fish, this guy has no scales, but is a slippery critter with slimy skin similar to that of an eel. They're roughly 6 inches long and are found at depths of 6,000 feet. This fish boasts bioluminescent body parts, which some believe is how it communicates with other fish or provides it with camouflage. Like many deep sea dwellers, this dragonfish uses a lighted barbell to attract its prey. Some dragonfish have the ability to glow red, which is also believed to attract prey. Number 17, xenophyophores. Way down in the bottom of the trench, you'll come across single-celled organisms called xenophyophores. If you find a xenophyophore in shallower parts of the ocean, they're usually not so big. However, it's believed that they've adjusted their size due to their environment – cold temperatures, high pressure, and a lack of sunlight. These xenophyophores are immune to many elements and chemicals that would usually destroy any type of sea life. They're tolerant to uranium, mercury, and lead, amongst other things. They've been spotted at depths of 6,000 feet into the trench and were first described in the 1970s. When they were first spotted, they were assumed to be sponges, but on closer studying, they were concluded to be single, gigantic cells. Number 16, Dumbo octopus. Definitely one of the cuter specimens to encounter down in the Mariana Trench. Let's meet the Dumbo octopus. No surprises where this little guy got its name from. Just look at the floppy ear-like fins on him. They grow between 8 and 12 inches usually, but the largest one ever recorded was 6 feet and 32 inches. At that size, it's probably not as cute anymore. Despite their sweet looks, they are fierce predators and like to dine on copepods, isopods, bristleworms, and amphipods, which they swallow whole. They're found at depths of 9,800 to 13,100 feet, and they live between 3 and 5 years. Number 15, benthocodone. Jellyfish are pretty common, but this particular one is not quite as common. It's found at depths of 2,500 feet, sometimes right on the seafloor, and has an opaque reddish tint to its body. They've got a rounded top and are surrounded by 1,500 red tentacles which propel it through the water. They like to eat small crustaceans as well as foraminiferans, which are tiny unicellular organisms. Scientists believe the reason why the jellyfish has a red tint to it is to mask the bioluminescent glow of some of the animals it's eaten. Number 14, amphipods. These deep sea creatures bear a striking resemblance to large fleas, and they've been discovered at depths of 5,600 feet in the ocean. These scavengers feast on debris from decaying plant and animal matter that has made its way to the ocean floor. Plus, they also make a great food source for other larger animals that are found down there. Number 13, pure liquid CO2. We mentioned the hydrothermal vents earlier, which basically spew out that very hot water. However, there's a vent that's been found in the trench that doesn't release hot water, but pure liquid carbon dioxide. The Okinawa Trough near Taiwan is home to the champagne vent of the Mariana Trench, and it's the only place underwater where this liquid carbon dioxide exists. It was discovered in 2005, and many believe these vents to be where life initially began. But that's another video entirely. Number 12. Decapods. At depths of 4,500 feet in the Mariana Trench, you might be able to spot a decapod. These can be in the form of lobsters, crabs, or prawns, and they've been seen in the Kermadec and Japan trenches. Researchers believe that the shrimp no longer existed in the trenches, but many were discovered not too long ago, along with a supergiant amphipod said to be 20 times larger than their closer-to-land counterparts. Number 11. Goblin sharks. Thank goodness these sharks are found in the trenches and not closer to land, as it would be a major driving force in keeping people out of the oceans. Considered a living fossil, these sharks have been swimming in the trenches for millions of years with little change to how they look and act. They're pretty unattractive sharks with sensors on their flat snouts helping to detect electrical currents, which gives them a heads up that prey is nearby. They swim close to the ocean floor, sweeping those snouts back and forth, searching for prey. When a meal is spotted, they launch their body forward and encapsulate their prey. The largest goblin shark on record was 10 feet long. Number 10. Sea devil anglerfish. Any animal with the word devil in the name is one to be avoided, and thankfully, this one is found deep in the Mariana Trenches, so that's one less thing for you to worry about. This unattractive fellow has a misshapen body, super sharp teeth, and a stare as cold as ice. Thankfully, they're not very big, and larger females reach only around 8 inches tops. To add to their unfortunate name, the male fuses itself with the female, losing its fins, teeth, and eyes, leaving behind what the female would need for reproduction. Like other anglerfish, the sea devil anglerfish has a protrusion from its forehead to lure its prey in. Its large jaw allows this fish to eat prey much larger than itself. Number 9. Clams. It's always been believed that anything that can survive in the trenches doesn't have shell or bones, because it would be very difficult to accommodate shell and bones with the intense pressure down there. That's why you find animals like sea cucumbers or the giant amoeba that can adjust to the pressure. However, a recent discovery brought up clams, which does put a different spin on the original theory. The clams were discovered in 2012 near serpentine hydrothermal vents, where the rocks were rich in life-giving minerals. It's not known yet how the clams have evolved to have their shells so strong under the immense pressure, but it's only hopefully a matter of time before we find out. Number 8. Rat-tail fish. These fish, also known as grenadiers, are one of the oldest fish families in the ocean. Strangely, they're closely related to the cod. These fish are not only found in shallower waters, but many inhabit the deep waters of the Mariana Trench. They have a remarkable sense of smell and eat other small fish and crustaceans. They're slow-moving and generally conserve their energy for the hunt. Number 7. Deep sea hatchet fish. No guesses as to why this deep sea fish is called a hatchet fish, and a number of these guys have been spotted in the Mariana Trench. There are more than 40 different species of this fish, and they generally all grow around 6 inches. They sport bioluminescent bodies, and depending on how much light is filtering from above, they can alter the amount of light their bodies give off. The dimmer the light they give off, the less chance they have of producing a silhouette, making it more of a challenge for predators to spot them. Number 6. Ooze. There's no better word to describe what you would most likely be standing on if you were to ever make yourself to the very bottom of the Mariana Trench. Don't think you're going to be exposed to lovely sand like you find on the beach, but rather a disgusting ooze that has trickled through the depths and settled at the bottom. Everything from crushed shells to the corpses of plankton have made their way to the bottom. The sludge would be grayish-yellow, fine, and almost silky in texture. You have to wonder what it would smell like if you ever did make your way to the bottom. Number 5. Protists. We mentioned earlier that the deepest part of the Mariana Trench is called the Challenger Deep, and it's just under 36,000 feet. There, you will find a life form called a protist. They're not animals, but rather single-celled organisms that are believed to be some of the very first life forms here on Earth. Number 4. Frilled sharks. This crazy-looking shark is said to be around for 80 million years, and little has changed in its appearance. The shark has 6 rows of frilly gills, which reach up to 6 feet long. The shark also has over 20 rows of sharp teeth that will do severe damage to anything that crosses its path. Luckily, they prefer the bottom of the ocean, and although one has been caught on the odd occasion, they don't survive, making it impossible to study them. Number 3. A monument. Okay, not in the way that you're thinking, but when George W. Bush was still in power, he signed a document that designated the Mariana Trench as a national monument. So, although you can't get down there now and buy your souvenirs, perhaps it's only a matter of time before you can. Now that it's a national monument, fishing and mining in the trenches is strictly forbidden. You can swim though, although we're not sure you'd want to, considering, you know, everything on this list. Number 2. Telescope octopus. These bizarre-looking deep-sea dwellers don't flit across the ocean floor like regular octopi, but rather drift through the waters at around 6,500 feet. They also don't swim horizontally, but suspend themselves vertically, possibly to distract predators. The telescope octopus is almost see-through, and there's a delicate webbing between its tentacles, giving it a ghostly shape. Number 1. Big, fat, nothing. Of course, there's not just nothing, considering what we've already mentioned, but in 2012, James Cameron made a trip into the trench. When he was down there, he said all he could see, barring the occasional inch-long prawn, was absolutely nothing. He described it as lunar, desolate, isolated. And when he was down there, he felt complete isolation from all of humanity. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe for more daily content.